Pascal's name and pistol.
You burglary cheese!
I is no matter.
How now, Mephistopheles?
I is no matter.
Slice, I say. Slice!
That's my humor.
Very simple, my man. Can you tell, cousin?
Pistol.
He hears with ears.
Pistol, did you pick Mr. Slender's purse?
I buy this glove to me, or I might never step into my great chamber again else. Of $80 in crisp 20s and 2 Edward Shuffle boards, which I paid 2 20s and 2 dimes for a piece of E. Miller. Buy these gloves.
Is this true, Pistol?
Sir John and Mastermind, I combat challenge of this blatant Bilbo. Word of denial in thy labyrinth here. Word of denial, froth and scum thou liest.
Buy these gloves then. Pussy!
Be advised, sir, and pass good humors. I will say merry track with you. If you run the nut puts humor on me, that is the very note of it.
Then he in the red face had it, for though I cannot remember what I did when you made me drunk, yet I knock together and ask.
What say you then?
Why, sir, for my part, I say, the gentleman had drunk himself out of his 5 senses.
Is his 5 senses? What the ignorance is.
But have heard all these matters denied.
And being fat, sir, was as I say cashiered, and so conclusions run the careers.
I used to speak in Latin then too. But 'tis no matter. I'll never be drunk once I live again. But honest, civil, godly. For this trick, if I'll be drunk, I'll be drunk with the fear of God.
Nadora, carry the wine in. We'll drink within.
Though heaven may decrease it upon day of better acquaintance. When we are married and have occasion to one another, I hope that upon familiars you will grow content. But if you say marry her, I will marry her. That I am freely dissolved and disillusioned.
I think you meant well.
I wrote my hand a lot.
Here comes Fairy Anne. Oh, Miss Anne, would I were young!
think so. Either bears in the town?
I think there are, sir. I've heard them talked of.
I love this sport well, but I abhor at it as any man in Connecticut. You are afraid if you see the bear loose, are you not?
Aye, indeed, sir.
That's meat and drink to me now. I have seen Saperson loose 20 times and have taken it by the chain. But I warned the woman have so cried and shrieked at it that it passed. But indeed, women cannot abide by them. They're such ill-favored rough things.
Hand out this letter to Mrs. Page, and that this to Mrs. tightly and say like my penis to these golden shores. Rogues head avaunt, perish like hailstones, go. From drugs, what owner who seeks out your pack? Falstaff will know the humor of the age. French thrifty rogues, myself and skirted page.
Mettez-le dans mon bouquet. Dépêche, quickly! Slender, same to you. Rugby. Buy me some paper. Down you a little while. Letter to Monsieur Slender? By God! It is a challenge! I shall cut his throat in the park, and I shall teach this Jacquinet priest to meddle or meck! You sure, Mingo? It is no good to you a dairy here. By God, I shall cut all his tour stones, and by God, he will not have a stone to throw at his dog! Myself. I shall kill the Jacques priest, and I have appointed my lord the Jacquier to measure a weapon. Because I will kill the Jacques priest.
Sir, the maid loves you, and all shall be well. We must give folks leave to pray with the good cheer.
Ruby, follow me to the court. By God, if I will not have unbashed myself, I shall throw your head out of the door! Follow my heels, Rigby!
You shall! You shall have Anne's head!
Here's head your own. No, I know Anne's mind for that. Never a woman in Windsor knows more of Anne's mind than I do, nor can do what I do with her.
How does pretty Miss Anne?
Why, she's pretty and kind and gentle, and one that is your friend. I may tell you that. I thank heaven for it.
Shall I do any good thing, Estelle? Shall I not lose my suit?
Well, in troth, all is in his hands above. But I'll be sworn upon a book the maid loves you. Does not your worship have a wart above your eye?
Yes, marry.
Thank you.
not my wife, but I would be loath to turn them together. A man may be too confident. I would have nothing lie on my head. I cannot be thus satisfied. Though Paige be a secure fool and stand so firmly on his wife's frailty, yet I cannot put off my opinion so easily. She was in his company at Paige's house, and what they made there, I know not. Well, I will look further into it. And I have a disguise to sound false now. If I find her honest, I lose not my my labor. If she be otherwise, 'tis labor well bestowed.
Is a you will, take what you will, pray all, take all, go to bed when she lists, rise when she lists, all is one with her, and she deserves it, for if there be a kind woman in Windsor, she is one.
I will. But I pray thee, Mrs. Ford and Mrs. Page acquaint each other of how they love me.
No, they were a jest indeed. They have not so little grace. They were a trick indeed. But Mrs. Page desires me to bring her little page of old love. Her husband has a marvelous affection to the little page. And look you, he may come and go between the two of you. And you may have a neighbor, but you understand one another fine. And he must never understand a word of it. Children must not need to know such wickedness. And adults are, they don't know the world.
Why, I will commend you to them both. This news distracts me. Sayest thou so, old Jack? Go thy ways. I'll make more of thy old body than I have. Will they yet look after me? Will I, after the expense of so much money, be now a gainer? Let them say 'tis grossly done, so that it be fairly done. It is no matter. Mrs. Ford, Mrs. Page, have I encompassed you? Don't you hear?
Opportunities to meet her, feed every slight occasion that could but catch a glimpse of her, not only bought many presents to give her, but have given largely to many to know what she would have given. Briefly, I have pursued her as love hath pursued me. Which hath been on the wing of all occasions. But whatsoever I have merited, either in my mind or in my means, I am certain I have received. Unless experience be a jewel, then I have purchased at an infinite rate, and that hath taught me to say this. Love, like a shadow, flies when the sun flies.
a gentleman, you shall, if you will, have for his wife.
Bless you, sir.
I say you shall.
Wants no money, Sir John, you shall want none.
What, no, Mrs. Ford, Mr. Brooke, thou shalt want none. Ooh. I shall be with her, I may tell you, by her own appointment, for even as you came in to me, her assistant or go-between parted from us. Just between 10 and 11, for at that very time, her name husband will be hence. Come to me at your convenient leisure, and you shall know how I speed.
I am blessed in your acquaintance. Do you know Ford, sir?
Hang him, poor cuckoo-man! I know him not, yet I wrong him to call him poor. They say the knave have masses of money, for which his wife is well favored. I will use her as the key to the cuckoldy rogue's coffer. Fire my heart.
Sir, that you might avoid him if you saw him.
Hang him, mechanical salt butter rogue. I will stare him out of his wits. I will awe him with my cudgel. Dominate him with a peasant, and you shall lie with his wife. Come to me, Slender, for a name, and you shall know him for such. Come to me soon as night.
What a damned Epicurean rascal is this? Oh, my heart is ready to crack with impatience. Who says this is improvident jealousy? My wife had set him. The hour is fixed. The match is made. Would any man have thought this? Oh, see the hell of having a false woman. My bed shall be abused. My coffers ransacked. My reputation gnawed at. And I shall not only stand this villainous wrong, but stand under the adoption of abominable terms, and by him that does me this wrong. Terms. Names. A Maimon sounds well. Lucifer, well. Barbasson, well, yet they are devil's additions, the names of fiends. But cuckold? Yeah! Whittle! Cuckold! The devil himself had not such a name. Page is an ass, a secure ass. He will trust his wife, he'll not be jealous. Adam will rather trust a Fleming with my butter. A Welshman with my cheese, an Irishman with my aqua vitae. To walk my ambling gal, and then my wife with herself. Then she plots, then she ruminates, then she devises. And what they think in their hearts, they may effect. They will break their hearts, but they will effect. God be praised for my jealousy. 11 o'clock the hour. I will prevent this. Be revenge on Falstaff. Detect my wife and laugh at Paige. Ha! all about. Better 3 hours too soon than a minute too late. Five. Cuckold? he had no use of them. Why, this boy will carry a letter 20 mile as easy as a cannon will shoot point blank 12 score. Oh, he pieces at his wife's inclination. He gives her folly motion and advantage. And now she's going to my wife! And Falstaff's boy with her? A man may hear the shower sing in the wind. And Falstaff's boy with her! Oh, ho, ho, ho. Good plots, they are laid, and our revolted wives share damnation together. Well, I will take him, then torture my wife, pluck the borrowed veil of modesty from the so seeming Mrs. Lee. Himself for a secure and willful atte on. And to these violent proceedings, all my neighbors shall cry, aim! The clock gives me my cue. My assurance bids me search. There I shall find Falstaff. I shall be rather praised for this than mocked, for it is as positive as the earth is firm that Falstaff is there. I will go.
Well, next.
Quickly, you tell me so much. Hey, zoot, the Lord, the pentonies is a big bell ring around your hand.
No, I promise you, the gentleman is of no having. He keeps no peace. He's a fool high region. He knows too much. No, he shall not in and on his substances with the finger of my fortune. The word I have waged on my consent, and my consent goes not that way.
I beseech you heartily. Some of you go home with me to dinner. Besides your cheer, you shall have sport. I will show you a monster.
Oui, oui.
Doctor, you shall go. So shall you, Mr. Hayes. Will you go, gentlemen?
Let's go.
Thank you.
lady.
I, your lady, Sir John. Alas, I should make a pitiful lady.
What the fuck? My eyes would emulate the diamond. I have the right arch beauty, the brow that becomes the ship tire, the tire valiant, or any tire of Venetian admittance.
A plain kerchief, Sir John. My brow becomes nothing else, nor that well neither.
Thou art a traitor to say so. Thy foot would make an excellent motion.
Oh,
no. I can see with thou art nature thy foe, or not fortune thy friend. Thou canst not hide it.
Believe me, there is no such thing in me.
What made me love thee? Let that persuade thee. There's something extraordinary. Come, I cannot cog and say that there are this or that, like many of these lisping huff-forged butts. Women in men's apparel smell like buckles bearing at simple time. I cannot, but I love thee, none but thee. Thou deservest it.
Do not betray me, sir. I fear you love Mrs. Page.
Thou mightest love her. I love to walk by the counter gate, which is as hateful to me as the reek of lime kiln.
Well, heaven knows how I love you, and you shall one day find it.
Keep in that mind, and I'll deserve it.
Nay, I must tell you so you do, or else I could not be in that mind.
Mrs. Ford! Mrs. Ford! I need to speak with you directly!
She should not see me. I will scar.
She's a very taxing woman. Oh, Mrs. Ford, what have you done? You're shamed, you're overthrown, you're undone forever. What's the matter, good Mrs. Ford? Yay, Mrs. Ford.
my keys. Ascend my chamber. Search, seek, find out. I warrant will and kennel the futz. Oh, let me stop this way first. So, now escape.
Good Mr. Ford, be contented. You wrong yourself too much.
True, Mr. Page. Gentlemen, you shall see sport anon. Follow me, gentlemen.
My little dainty humor.
Okay. What do you guys think of the show so far?
It's hilarious.
We're technically flabbergasted from the names, though. These are not Shakespeare names. Huh? Oh, no. Wendy definitely chopped up the script.
You know what? She'll be like my new
name. It's just
Shakespeare writing a show. It's
a non-conventional show. Yeah. Also, this is like the, like, feminist play Shakespeare wrote. If
and they go to such lengths to avoid giving the wives names.
I know.
There's a gentleman who lives in Windsor. She is married to
her husband's name is Cole. Yeah.
Which is just like
such lengths. And there's the subplot of like Anne, like the daughter. There's a third subplot too. It's probably because no one wanted to be part of the show because the entire semester was such an L. This show is cursed.
Yes.
Whoa. I'm so happy Chris got canceled before.
Oh, good.
Yeah. First got canceled because everybody was just so busy with the semester.
Trying towards one, so it sounds like it was a mixed bag.
That's true. I think people are so. I think it might happen one more time, and if it's once in a mixed bag, it's because it's an unbelievable amount of effort.
Yeah. Certainly the first time you do anything, it's not really what you go in the second time with a better idea of what to expect.
So I know that, like, Harvard undergrad theater group. New York City, and then after they take their set to New York City, and then afterwards they just leave it on the street corner. And then they also, because they have a lot of money, they also go to the Caribbean and do another show in the Caribbean using the most minimal set you can possibly think of.
That's amazing.
That's what?
Yeah, it's pretty wild.
Yeah.
And they ship everyone for free, and that's their spring break, is New York City.
That's amazing.
Wow. They're not, definitely not doing this show.
I assume.
They also write their own, like, drags. Everyone.
Wow.
Hello. Hi, Mary.
Mary. There are eight windows. Two of them have been used.
Yes.
I know.
One of them open.
Okay. I just want to. This is fantastic.
I know you two, among others, are
set designers and
sponsors. Almost all the panels, except for one window, we finished painting it all before putting it in.
Yeah, when you look at the cast list and then the tech crew.
Yeah, like Colin was reflecting, oh, I don't know anybody who's acting, but I know a lot of the tech people.
Yeah, that's
a
And also trying to start a
I've heard whispers of this.
Wow, the Constitution. I wrote the Constitution in the
Is this for like non-musical,
non-Shakespeare? Non-musical, non-Shakespeare, non-ambitious tech.
So, 100%.
We have specifically, the point of it is like if you want theater to be like fourth or fifth on your priority list of everything you love, you can do it.
Nice.
So we're gonna do like way shorter than that. I have no fucking idea!
You'll be gone by the time it evolves into a nightmare monster.
I know!
We'll see, we'll drop the show.
Nobody wants to do NPA shows because they're all weird experimental messes. Last semester, they did a show where the actors didn't know any of the lines and you're just spending two
earpieces.
What? You didn't know this?
Yeah!
See that?
You should talk to Alexander because he was involved in that show and he said he was the biggest shit show he's ever seen.
That's who was directing it? Jay Shive, I'm guessing? Okay, I assume Jay Shive.
It's about a beard.
That's so proud.
Beard is so good.
Also, the night for that show apparently
also,
was
you found the
shit
greatest
show all
time.
The actor was just
it was also the cheapest one.
Literally, I've not heard the play.
Literally, I pulled out three options and I was like, this one's my favorite. It's $10 less than either of the others.
I was not involved.
Elsie looks horrible in the test. We're just like, is he selling him insurance or a used car?
Anyway, so if you don't like musicals,
Shakespeare,
and Snowflake, I would like
to. I heard there's a group
of oh, yeah, there's a lot of streaming.
Can you send me the link so I can send it to my mother?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, no, they're starting. Goddamn. After the show. I have it right here in this box.
Cool.
There's the miss.
Tells me 'tis a thing impossible. I should love thee but as a property.
Maybe he tells you true.
No. Heaven so speed me in my time to come. Albeit, I will confess thy father's wealth was the first motive that I wooed thee. Yet wooing thee, I found thee of more value than stamps and gold or sums and sealed bags. And 'tis the very riches of thyself that now I aim at.
Gentle Master Fenton, yet seek my father's love. Still seek it, sir. If opportunity and humblest suit cannot attain it, but hark you hither.
Break their talk this quickly. My kinsman shall speak for himself.
Aye, I will. I'll make a falter silent. It is but venturing.
Be not dismayed.
She will not dismay me. I care not for that.
Pray you,
but
a word with you.
Mr. Slender would speak a word with you.
I come to him. That is my father's choice.
tell you how things go better than I. You may ask your father. Oh, here he comes.
And now, Mr. Slender. I love him, Daughter Anne. How now, Mr. Fenton? You wrong me, Sir Duster, to haunt my house. I told you my daughter is disposed of.
Nay, Mr. Payne, be not impatient.
Good Mr. Fenton, come
not to
my child.
She's of no majesty.
Sir, will you hear me?
No, good Mr. Fenton. Come, son Slender. Knowing my mind, you wrong me, Mr. Fenton.
Good Mrs. Page, for that I love your daughter in such a righteous fashion as I do, but force against all checks, rebukes, and manner, I must advance the colors of my love and not retire. Let me have your good will.
Good mother, do not marry me to yon fool.
Why not? I seek you a better husband.
That's my master, Master Doctor. Alas, I would rather be set quick at the earth and bold to death with turnips.
Thus, like a borrowed of butcher's offals thrown into the Connecticut River. Well, if I am to be served another trick, I'll have my brains taken out and serve them to a dog for a New Year's gift. The rogues lighted me into the river with as little remorse as they would a blind bitch's puppies, 15 in the litter. Thou know by my size I have a kind of alacrity to sink in. If the bottom were as deep as hell, I should doubt. But that the fresh bottom was shelvy and shallow. Oh, a depth that I abhor. For the water swells a man. What a thing should I have been had I been swelled. I would have been a mountain of mummy.
I pray your mercy, give your worship good morrow.
Oh, how now?
I come from Mrs. Ford.
Mrs. Ford, I've had Ford enough. I was thrown into a Ford and my belly full. So did I mine, to build upon a foolish woman's promise.
Well, Schumann said that would yearn your heart to see it. Her husband this morning goes averting. She much more desires you to come see her between the hours of 8 and 9. I must carry her word quickly. She'll make you amends, I warn you.
Well, I will not miss her. Tell her so. Bid her consider what a man is. Let her think on his frailty. And then judge me of my merit.
I will tell her.
Between 9 and 10, sayest thou?
10 and 11.
Oh, very well, I will tell her.
Farewell to your worship.
I warrant I hear nods of Mr. Brooke. I like his money well.
Bless you, sir.
Well, sir, I will not lie to you. But the peeking corn new to her husband, blowing in a continual larum of jealousy, comes into us in the instant of our encounter, after we had embraced, kissed, roasted, and spoken the prologue of our company, and at his heels, a rabble of his companions, thither provoked and instigated by his distemper, to search the house for his wife's lover.
What, while you were there?
While I was there.
And did he search for you and could not find you?
Oh, nay, you shall hear as good luck would have it. In comes one Mrs. Payne, gives intelligence of Ford's approach and her invention and Ford's wife's distraction. They conveyed me into a buck basket.
A buck basket?
By the Lord! Buck basket! Rammed me in with foul shirts and smocks, socks, dirty napkins, foul linens. That there, Mr. Brooke, was the rankest compound of villainous smells that ever offended us.
How long lay you there?
Nay, but you shall hear, Mr. Brooke, what I have suffered to bring this woman to evil for your good. Being thus crammed in the basket, a couple of Ford's knaves, his hinds, were called in by their mistress to take the clothes up to Datchet's mean laundry. Well, they took me up on their shoulders and met the knave, their Lord Ford, at the door, who asked them once or twice what they had in the basket. I, quite with fear, lest the lunatic knave should discover me, but Lord ordaining he should be a cuckoo, held his head. Away went I for foul clothes, and away went he for a search. But mark the sequel, Miss Sober. I suffered the pangs of three separate deaths. First, an intolerable fright to be discovered by a jealous, rotten bellow. Then, to be compassed in the circumference of a pen, like a good billboard, hilt to heel, point to tip, and then to be stopped up like a strong distillation with foul clothes. Think on that, a man of my kidney. Think of that, as subject to heat as butter, a man of continual disillusion and thaw. It is a miracle I escaped suffocation. And then, on the height of that bath, when I was more than half stewed in grease, like a Dutch dish, to be towed into the Connecticut River and cooled, hissing hot, like a horseshoe. Think on that, hissing hot. Think on that.
In good sadness, I am sorry, sir, that you have suffered all this for my sake. My suit's then is desperate. You'll undertake her no more.
Mr. Brooke, I will be thrown into Edna, as I have been into Connecticut. Here I will leave her thus. I have her another twixt of meeting. Between 9 and 8, and 9 is the hour, Mr. Brooke.
It's past 8 already, sir.
Is it? Well, I will then speed me to my appointment. Crunch me as you convene, and you shall know how I speak. Afford a name, and thou shalt lie with his wife. Adieu!
Oh, is this a vision? Is this a dream? Do I sleep? Oh, wait, Mr. Ford, wait. There's a full maid in your best coat. Mr. Ford, this tis to be married. This tis to have linen
now!
hair's breadth. Not only in the simple office of love, but in all the accoutrement, complement, and ceremony of it. Are you sure of your husband now?
He's a birding sweet, Sir John. What ho, Bathacore! What ho! Step into the chamber, Sir John.
A conspiracy against me! Now that
modest wife, the virtuous creature that hath the jealous fool to her husband. I suspect without cause, mistress, do I?
Heaven be my witness, you do, if you suspect me in any dishonesty. Any further revenge. The spirit of wantonness is
this well. Be not as extreme in submission as in offense. Whatever lies yet once again in this public sport, find that old fat fellow. Find him and we will disgrace him.
Mary, this is our device. The Falstaff at the Garter shall meet with us dressed as a buck, as though he has heard the hunter.
Oh, well, let it not be doubted, but he'll come. And in this shape, when you have brought him thither, what shall be done with them? What is your plot?
That likewise we have thought upon, and thus, Nan Cage, my daughter, and two or three more of growth will dress like aliens in green and white. Upon the sudden, as Falstaff, she and I are newly met, let them from forth and rush at once to the tune of some diffused song. Upon their sight, we two in great amazingness shall fly, and let them all encircle him about. And till he tell the truth, let the supposed aliens pitch him sound. The truth being known, we'll all present ourselves to spoil the spirit and mock him home to win him.
That will be excellent. I'll go and buy the masks and daedalic rings.
Find Nan to be the leader of all the aliens. Find me attired in a robe of white.
That suit would I go by. In that time, shall Mr. Slender go and marry my daughter? Go find me some Falstaff.
Nay, I'll school him again in name of Brook. He'll tell me all his purpose.
Sure.
He'll come.
Fear not you that. Look at his properties and trickings for our aliens. Go find Miss Quickly, Sir John. Rose Bond. All to the doctor. He hath my goodwill, and none but he to marry with Nan Cage. That Slender, though well landed, is an idiot. And he, my husband, best of all effects. The doctor is well moneyed, his friends potent at court. He and none but he shall have her. Though 20,000 worthier come to crave her.
Slender and immediately to marry. She hath consented. Her mother, ever strong against that match and firm for Dr. Keyes, hath appointed that he shall likewise shuffle her away. While other sports are tasking of their minds and at the deanery where a priest attends straight, will I marry her. To this, her mother's plot, she seemingly obedient, likewise hath made promise to the doctor. Now thus it rests. Her father means she shall be all in white. And in that habit, when Slender sees his time to take her by the hand and bid her go, she shall go with him. Her mother hath intended the better to denote her to the doctor, for they must be masked and visited. That quaint in green, she shall be loose and robed with ribbons pendant flaring about her head.
And when the doctor spies his vantage right to pinch her by the hand and on that token, the maid hath given consent to go with him. Both father and mother will be deceived, and Anne will go along with me. I'll procure the vicar to stay for me at church twixt 12 and 1, and in the lawful name of marrying, to give our hearts united ceremony.
Pretty, no more prowling dogs. I'll home. This is the third time. I hope good luck lies in odd numbers. Away, go! Why there is a divinity in odd numbers, either in nativity, chance, or death. Away, I said!
I'll get you a chain and see if I can fetch you a pair of horns.
Away, time wears. Hold up your head and mince. Rain potatoes. Let it thunder to the tune of green seas. Hail received so gross overreaching as this one. This time I have a coxcomb for his head. This time I were choked on a piece of toasted cheese.
Why, little Donald, do you think that for the virtue out of our hearts for the head and shoulders, we would have given ourselves without scruple to anyone but our husbands?
You have the starter knife in your hand. Use me as you will. Ignorance itself is a plummet over me. Use me.
Mary, sir, we'll bring you to Windsor, to one of Mr. Brooke, to whom you should have been a pander. I think to repay that money would be biting affliction.
Yeah, be cheerful, knight. Thou shalt even posset tonight at my house, where I shall desire thee to laugh at my wife, and then thou laugh at thee.
Doctor, stop that. If Ned Page be my daughter, she shall be the doctor's wife.
Oh, ho, Father Page.
Son, how now? How now, son? Have you dispatched?
Dispatched? I'll make the best of winter. No one is. Without wearing hangcloth else.
Of what, son?
I came yonder to marry Miss Anne Page. And here she is. Miss Anne Page, and I might never stir.
You have been misguided.
Oh, yeah.
shut down the stream now. Bye, Casey.
I'm in your way.
Yeah.
Oh no, did my phone die?